here's a postscript to my show a few weeks ago about author Cindy Ross, who walked from Canada to Mexico with her husband and two small children. You might remember that Ross and her husband, Todd Gladfelter of New Ringgold in Schuylkill County, were experienced hikers who both covered the Appalachian and Pacific Crest Trails before children came along. Unwilling to stop hiking, but unable to carry the children and their belongings, including 100 cloth diapers in their backpacks, they packed the children and their gear onto llamas. Walking 500 miles during a summer, they completed the 3,100-mile trip over 6 years. By that time, their daughter Sierra was 8 and their son Bryce was 6. That expedition, though, didn't end the family's adventures. As Ross writes in her latest book, The World is Our Classroom, how one family used nature and travel to shape an extraordinary education. They visited friends in the Swiss Alps, rode elephants in Thailand, and canoed through the Everglades. The education that Bryce and Sierra received about the natural world and other cultures positioned them for rewarding careers. Sierra, a Fulbright scholar, has done research on climate change and disasters in Nepal and India. Bryce has become an illustrator, following the path of both parents. Ross is an artist as well as an author, and Gladfelter makes furniture and sculpts with a chainsaw. During Ross's talk at the Whitehaven Library on October 10th, she said the outdoors provided a great place for parents to spend time with their children. The children learned by modeling their parents' behavior, but also from seeing. For example, they watched beavers swim and saw how beaver dams pushed up the water level. Ross and Gladfelter supplemented lessons by imparting children and engaging them on topics such as how trees grow and researching answers to questions that the children asked. Not every parent has the skills to lead children on a months-long trip in the wilderness, but they can take the kids car camping in a state park, Ross said. And does foreign travel seem beyond your budget? For the price of a Disney vacation, Ross and Gladfelter said they went to Sicily, where they found long-lost relatives and helped with the olive harvest. Other lessons cost them much less. They hosted an exchange student from Ecuador and learned about Ecuador that way. They paired their children with patient researchers, including the scientists from Hawk Mountain near their home, and just building that home out of logs by themselves after taking a week-long DIY course allowed the family to be free of debt and therefore able to free up time to spend with their children and to travel. You're the creators of your own lives, Ross told her children. The words ring in my ears now as an example, and may for other parents.